Kama Sutra is about pleasure, not about sex. Okay, sex is a very physical act that anybody can indulge in the act of sex. Pleasure is something that only the human mind can actually understand and indulge in. Pleasure is a much longer lasting thing, and it's actually extremely good for you, and it is something that actually takes you to a whole different height. It's supposed to elevate you. It's supposed to make you reach certain heights that you can't otherwise reach. We'll talk about how elegant and beautiful and refined this whole world is. It's nothing like we think of the act of sex today. And it talks about this refinement and this beauty in such a way, because in ancient times they believed that everything had to start from the point of physical intimacy. They believed that if a couple could share really, really good, mutually pleasurable intimacy, that means that the relationship would be stable. If the relationship was stable, society would be stable. If society was stable, the kingdom would be stable.
Beautiful.
So this was about the bigger picture. It was about, they literally believed back in that time that success in any part of your life, whether you were a warrior, whether you're an economist, whether you're a trader, whatever it is that you did, success in any part of your life depended on your success in your physical, intimate life. And eventually, if the aim is to reach God, all love has to first begin at the physical level before you can start to elevate it. So I guess that's what I mean when I say that, you know, it, and hence it's not about sex. Because sex, the act of sex is on its own, it doesn't mean very much. It was about pleasure. It was about arousal. It was about desire. Because, of course, in ancient times, again, we believed that the highest form of energy is the sexual energy. I mean, you're a sports person. You know that if you're out there running or doing a certain amount of exercise, it gets your metabolism going. They believe that when you have arousal, when you're in the state of pleasure and elevating pleasure, there is more metabolism in your body than even when you exercise, because every part of your body goes into some form of activity. Your heart rate, right. Your breathing, your hormones are being secreted, everything. And eventually, if you consider, this is where, if you carry this pleasure to its final point, this is how you can create life. Only God can create life. So, you know, this was considered the highest form of energy because it's that powerful.